good evening. I think most of you already know me because I am one of the organizers of the Data Science Cafe for Vienna Data Science Group. But today you are going to know me even a little longer. Basically, I'm from Latin America, that's my accent. I'm a Spanish native speaker, and I am a production engineer. I am a project management, I have a project management specialization, an MBA. With a very interesting exchange with the Manchester Business School, a very cultural, very diverse, I really enjoy it. And I am a data scientist, okay? So basically, today I'm exactly delivering the complement of the great program that you are bringing here. And it's more like the air that is in the middle of all these projects in data science. It's okay, we are briefing right now, there is air in this room, we don't exactly realize that it's there, but it's here. If not, we are not alive. Exactly the same, the soft skills and team building in data science, because it's diverse and because there are several challenges there. So, basically, this is a very introductory session, okay? Because the topic is huge and there are several perspectives, but if we ended this conversation with more questions than answers, we start the conversation and I'm going to be happy. We have said, really, I want you to just exactly question this kind of soft skills. We are talking about legal, marketing, all this stuff, and soft skills. It's, give me a break. But believe me, they are important. And more important here, in bringing this message from a data science perspective, not from a human resources perspective, okay? So the agenda is very easy, diverse, data science diverse by design, implications of diversity. This module of communications and skills and data science, yes, we prepare, is dense, okay? But it's just very introductory. And then just finishing with team building in data science from an organizational perspective, and more important, for a very personal perspective. So starting here, all data science, this have seen this. I just want to do streaming clustering here. Please raise your hand if you consider, I know that we are all kind of mix of this, but try just to one cluster, two cluster, second cluster, third cluster. Please raise your hand if you are coming from a computer science or you are more applying a computer science. Okay, as expected. Okay, math and statisticians, great. Business, okay. Good, no, but it's clustering. You could not be into clusters, we are just clustering. Strictly business, okay, two. So I'm going to start with two very strong statements, okay? But they are true. First, I am a minority, part of a minority, not because I am a woman, obviously I am, because I'm coming to data science from the business perspective. I, story, my whole life, and my 15 years of experience are coming from the business perspective. And I really enjoy your example that, yes, all the time was, it's not marketing by the way, it's finance, but operational finance, which means show me the money, which every data-driven decision connecting with the real operation of a business in different industries. Normally, Excel. Yes, we love Excel, although my partner there doesn't like it so much Excel. But yes, normally it was the kind of Excel, and then Excel with all the possibilities that we have in data science, not enough. And I said, well, if I already really enjoy data, I already know how to code some SQL, and I'm doing this, I have a perspective, why not coming to data science and learning coding? Yes, I could code, and yes, you could learn if you're coming from a business perspective. But I decided more to be here in the modeling part, not necessarily in the data engineer perspective, which I totally respect. It's a huge field and very interesting. I'm more the user of R, Python, and Julia, okay? The kind of modeling perspective. And second statement is, I know this presentation is kind of cliche. I'm a woman coming from business talking about soft skills. Kind of cliche. I know. I totally realize. I'm just, it's been love, because it is just starting the conversation. Completely cliche, but still, from a data science perspective, because being a data scientist, I know how to present these topics in your own terms, and that's the point, and it's exactly what I'm going to do. So, as I said, data science is diverse by design. Okay, I hadn't heard that, no, I wrote that, but it's easy to understand. Computer science, math, subject matter expertise, all together, it's easy to just agree, yes, it's diverse by design. But this diversity has several implications, and that's exactly the point of having these kinds of programs that the BU is delivering. First, the reality is very complex, okay? And if you are coming from a business perspective, which is my reality, sometimes it's like, if you are talking about Hadoop clusters, it's like, it's something different. Is this orange or is this blue? Is it a circle? Or is it a square? The reality, both. Because no one of us could really see the whole reality, could see just a projection of the reality. And every one of us, depending on which perspective we are taking, coming from here, or coming from here, or even coming from here, which is not reflected there, we are just having a perspective, okay? This is something that in a picture is easy to understand, but in the reality, we want to believe that is this or is that? No, it's all together. And if we combine, that's why it's so important, the team building, if we combine our skills to understand the whole reality, we could do, we could deliver better products. Indeed, part of why I decided to start this conversation today, it was like, there is so much value in data science, and there is so much value in the whole IT skills that are behind in the whole infrastructure, and sometimes I hear so quite often, business do not understand what I could do. We do, we really understand, but the communication process is complicated, and it's exactly the point with this model. Déjenme decirles, los quiero felicitar porque de verdad estamos creando el espacio más increíble revolucionando la economía digital. Es increíble lo que estamos logrando. If you see your faces right now, it's like, yes, love it, but it's like terrifying, okay? I just have, because I know there is one person in this audience that although could not speak Spanish, but he understood me, and he's laughing even more than everybody else. But the face was like, what's going on, okay? This is the thing with the communications code. If I just start talking to business, just poor business, it sounds that you could understand the words, but really the meaning, But if we are coming even from a computer science perspective, and we just start talking with the codes of a computer science, it's like exactly the same feeling that you have 30 seconds before. It's exactly the feeling that sometimes, and a diverse audience, others are having. It's like, okay, I could make a question, but where are you start? I'm not managing that code, okay? It's exactly the implications of the diversity, and we need to be aware that we are in data science, are dealing with this diversity in the codes. So very important here is, I reviewed this presentation with Ruth, and he reminds me a better example, not so shocking, like changing to Spanish so quickly and just like what is going on. It's more like coming to a new job at the very beginning, and everybody's talking, everybody feels integrated, and then, but you're the newcomer, it's, okay, what is this? What is this? What is this? Since the words, you could understand it, not like Spanish, it's more, okay, yes, I could recognize this, but still not getting the whole meaning, what is going on here. One tool is ask questions, always. What do you mean by that? There are three words, and even, are we in the same page? From which perspective are we coming? Normally, I try to spend 5 minutes at the very beginning asking questions to the person. where are you from, which is your profile, just to know how I'm going to adapt my codes to that person. And trying to find that field of common understanding, okay? It's like, okay, if this person, I could just choose some words that are more from here, or more from here, or more from here, or maybe in the middle. And there is an interesting tool, which is adaptive thinking hats. There is a huge theory, I'm just using adaptive, which is physically you could use some hats. Right now we are going to explain this project completely from a technical background. And we are going to explain this project completely from a modeling background or from a business background. And it is important to be able to do that because most of the outsiders of a data science project are going to be around here. And they are not going to understand for sure what is a cluster in Hadoop, what is an artificial intelligence, what is a deep learning, what is a neural network. It's like, if they don't have even the buzzword, the literacy is like, and that doesn't mean that there is value here and they could adopt the projects and the models that we are developing at, like data scientists, but they need to understand why they want to adopt this. Even they don't know all the details that are behind. And that's exactly the point. Just remember this of the unicorn. Probably you already have listened of the unicorn. It's normally related to one person that could do everything. Whoosh, really, it's not possible, but it's possible in teams. I'm coming back to this idea later. Preconceptions and mindsets. This is probably the dense part of the presentation. And I'm going to use some code. Sorry that it's copied here. We have some technical problems, but there is a Jupyter notebook in Julia, in my computer, that you could see if you want, okay? Who knows this Iris dataset? Okay, most of the, which is great. Basically, this is to, as you already know, it's very simple, very straightforward dataset to predict which species is this flower. And these two variables, as you will see in this exploratory graph, it's quite easy to really do some clustering and predict with these two variables what is going on, which is exactly why we normally see this example in a machine learning and particularly in the clustering. But now, let's assume that I don't have the time. I don't have time to really collect all these, not so long, there are 150, but let's say I don't have that time. I really need to predict the species, so very simple. I'm just going to create some random variables, like this one, D feature 1, D feature 2. I'm just going to create some clustering based on that. Just for comparison purposes, I just create a feature with the column 3 and 4. If you are, the code is in Julia, so it's slightly different than Python, but it's very easy to read. So basically, I just create with the column 3 and 4, which are the good predictors, and the 6 and 7 column, that are the random ones, okay? And of course, I get some clusters. This is the original one. This is the machine learning per se, which, okay, I could see that there are some points in the real life data that could make it confusing, okay? And this is the random one, okay? But you will see it's a terrible model, okay? Here, of course, I could see there are some greens. It's not that bad, there are some greens, but generally speaking, a terrible model. You will say, what's going on? Why is she doing this? Why is she creating this crappy model, this silly model? And the thing is, and that's the main point, I'm going to spend some minutes here, that's exactly the main point why soft skills are so important in data science. As I said, we have diversity. It's diverse by design, we could not choose. It's diverse, that's it. If we are in data science, it's diverse. So, we are judging with the random variables. My no such volunteer, please stand up. So, it's it's agreed in advance, don't worry. Let's see. He's tall. That's good. Good. He's wearing tennis. Not so good coming from business, but you know, Silicon Valley. Yeah, this is a competent guy. Yeah, for sure. Good. Thanks. Let's see this lady here. She's not so tall. Good. She's wearing black. Good. Probably not that competent. What happened? I know I'm making fun, but believe me, we use this, and it's not because we are bad people. There is a reason I'm going to explain that. But we use this to make very quickly decisions, which is complete. It's part of what we are doing. It's exactly the point of this Nobel Prize, Daniel Kahneman. Who has read Daniel Kahneman? Great, okay. I'm going to explain a little because it's around 30% of the audience that has read this. I would say one of the best books that I have ever read, and as it said, quite fast, read it slowly, because it's dense. But this guy is a Nobel Prize. He won his Nobel Prize in behavioral economics. And this behavioral economics, he proposed, there are plenty of information here, but I'm just going to focus on this, the system one and system two, okay? He proposed that we have a thinking fast, which is the system one, and a second one, which is the slow thinking system. The first system is fast, is unconscious, completely random, exactly what I did with Wolf and I. It's automatic, is everyday decisions, and error prone, because our random, okay? And preconceptions running behind. The system two is a slow. It's conscious, it's effortful, it means I need some time to really get more information and think about it. Complex decision and reliable. And you will say, but let's always work with the system two. Well, that's not possible. Why? First, because we are human beings, we are the best machine learning that have ever invented, but we are also, we want to survive. So basically, for a survival reason, the parameters that are in the human perception is always thinking system one. Why? If a lion appear right now, is he good or not? Just run. You just need to do the decision very. So in several situations, we need this system one. The thing is, that we move to a data science project, when we move to a professional environment, it's our setup. It's exactly like who codes with R. Okay, well, we don't have so much code R's, but basically there is one that is really as data frame the stream as normally is true, which most of the time is a lot is useful for some things, but normally it's okay. As data frame, a string, as factors, false. Exactly the same what we could do with our human perception function, okay? We have input the world. We need self-awareness, which normally is false for the same reason. We need to be quick, so we could not be like, oh, have a hand. Ooh, yes, it's happened. Normally we have false, but when we are working in a diverse environment where the confusion could be there because we are managing several codes because it's complicated and we are dealing with an interesting reality, self-awareness, true. And thinking system two, which means the slow one. Particularly when we are talking about projects in data science, okay? This is exactly what all the soft skills courses that are delivered by human resources focus on. They don't explain it in that way, but what they are trying is be aware of what is going on, have these tools, and just use it in that system number two. Because when you are working in teams, which is completely different on your everyday life, you are in a safe environment and you could perfectly work with these two parameters. Self-awareness, true, what is going with me and with the others. And thinking system two, just do it slowly, ask questions, and look for understanding, okay? Okay, good. I know it's dense, it's exactly why I said there are going to be more questions than answers. But if we start the conversation, is the point. Now, let's relax a little, okay? Recapping. We have a diverse environment, and we have some things that are in our professions, which manage different codes, and at the same time are how we are built like human beings, that we need just to work with them, okay? As we said, not working in a team, well, it's possible if it's very small, a small project, but data science per se is going to be normally a team project. And now I'm coming for the organizational perspective. This is around the 70s, where basically the rate of growing of the knowledge was not so quick, and one person, normally the lead, could learn everything and guide everybody. So we have more this kind of hierarchical projects. From around the 80s, we are starting to just move more knowledge, and nobody, just one person, could assume all this knowledge altogether. So we started more like changing the leadership style to coach, motivator, to create, and this. And we are now in the era of data science, creating new data-driven economies, and it's exactly, I foresee this, which is, okay, it's no one could assume everything. You could share leadership, but at the same time, it's not enough just sharing the leadership. You need to create knowledge and create innovation to really speed up with that curve that we are talking there. That gives a lot of space for being creative with the organizational perspective. If I will recommend Mo, which is right exactly here, I really like what his, the idea that he has it with his company is the kind of things that we are going to be in the future evolving, creating more crowd innovation. Coming from experts, more the joint, the bridge between organizational perspective and personal perspective is experts on data science. I think if you are here, we are data scientists, who is tired of people just using buzzwords in this field? Really, so few. I must say something like, it's coming, oh, artificial intelligence. What exactly is artificial intelligence? Big data. And it's just, and when you just think a little, you say, but this person is not necessarily understanding what is going on. And I don't care if someone doesn't know something specific about data science. What I really don't like is when someone is using just buzzwords to say, oh, I am a data scientist. Or I know what is going on. Buzzwords is great, but there is a certain level which is literacy. It means, okay, I know what is a buzzword, buzzwords are important, but at the same time, I know what is the meaning of this buzzword. And I could not apply it, but I have certain degree what is going on. A practitioner, yeah, someone that it could go on that direction, and an expert is someone that has spent a lot of time, and as soon as this person, she or he, sees a problem, knows, that is that. That's the expert. And there is a lot of value in having experts. The point here is you could borrow money in a bank, but no one could borrow time in a bank. Everybody in this world has time constraint, which means trade-off, okay? If I'm going to be specifically in this field, there is no one, absolutely no one, that could be an expert in all this and soft skills at the same time, by the way. So, the point here, there are no individual unicorns. Indeed, I don't like this reference, but the unicorn teams are perfectly viable. It's just that we need to have the right combination of an organizational perspective and a personal perspective. As I said, self-awareness is very important. I myself just decided, okay, I really have this, I probably hear from some of the business, and more, some of them practitioner, other with literacy. And I feel okay with that, because I want to identify who are my partners, who could complement me, and particularly not in implementing the infrastructure of a big data, the clusters, I'm not in that but I really respect the professionals that do that. And I have enough literacy to understand, and I'm completely willing to learn from my colleagues as I have done, and I plan to continue doing it, okay? So from a personal perspective, and it's very important, because sometimes this, I think the rejection that we have for the soft skills is that somehow they say like, there is something wrong with you. No, there is nothing wrong with anybody of us, okay? So it's all right to be you, but it's even better to be the best version of you, okay? And relationship with your colleagues are the best sources for feedback, exactly knowing what's going on, where I could improve at, and the best opportunity for partnering. I'm going to focus, it's all right to be you. For example, I love talking a lot, sometimes too much, okay? But I learn a little tweaks in the style, asking more. Then we have a conversation instead of a monologue, and at the same time, I learn more. So great, I am me, but still the best version of me. If you are shy, which is quite common, a shy person is extremely valuable for a team, okay? They normally have the time that I don't have because talking too much to see, yes, really, to see the face and analyze what is going on. So they have so much important input there, but somehow it's just, their value is gone. There is no value if they don't share that knowledge. But of course, openly coming here, share that knowledge that, I realize that is maybe too much. But this person could find another person that could feel comfortable. By the way, what if? And I learned that the exchange in Manchester, particularly our Asian cultures are more shy. It's a generalization, but yeah. And I was all the time when I saw the face of an Asian in my team, like, this person knows something, tell me. And normally, yes, it was like, okay, what? Tell me what is your opinion. Okay, good. Make some, and we really do very well in the projects because this person had very valuable input. So it's perfectly fine, it's just self-awareness. I talk too much, other person is too shy, other person prefer to be in the technical area, which is perfectly fine, and we need experts, real experts there, or others are prefer more dealing with people, which is great, okay? At the end, what is important here is find your own combination. Personally, I prefer that the whole thing have at least literacy, because if you have just experts and one integrator, then you just have like Iceland with a bridge that if this integrator is not there, then I really prefer that you have at least literacy on all the fields, and then the experts, that everybody knows this is the expert for this is the expert for that, and they could talk using the soft skills to combine their qualities. Just final message, data science is diverse by design, that makes everything interesting and enjoyable, okay? The diversity brings several perspectives and challenge, as we saw, which require a special focus on communications and soft skills. With the right combination of personal self-awareness, this works just if I am aware who I am and my impact on others, okay? And organizational infrastructure, yes, the companies has an important role here. Different experts could combine their knowledge to build a unicorn team in data science where the company and its professional achieve their common ground objectives. So this is the main message that I wanted to bring today. Probably a lot of questions, and hopefully you enjoy. Thanks. Okay, and thanks Wolf that helped me reviewing and finding the presentation. Questions?
What do you do if suddenly one of the unicorns in your team gets sick for a couple of weeks?
Okay, well, that's exactly the point why I prefer to have literacy. Normally, when you are working in projects, real life projects, you could have even if I'm not the expert in something, I could know this person is doing this, and somehow just move the task that this person is involved to here can just try to manage on this part. I learned in one of the companies that I work, we use the agile development project management methodology, and this allows exactly that kind of scenarios. Of course, if you have a deadline and the expert that is completely out, you need to look for a backup. But if everybody knows somehow what is everybody doing in a literacy level, you could just as this. If you have a network, it's easy. You could manage. If you could wait, just rearrange the task. It's exactly like a development criteria, and just give some time to this person.
Do you have particular tools or exercises for team building, like helping people to communicate and see the other perspective?
There are plenty. That's thanks for asking. As you may remember, we have several Data Science Cafe participants here, and there is one module, or one of the modes, which is the inspirational mode. And I insisted that behind there are games. These games, so far, nobody has used it, but it's okay, because the conversation is also in an inspirational mode. But in these games, there are ways of just playing, normally with post-its, to do exactly that. In a very relaxed way, it's just sometimes when you are gaming in an enterprise, it's like we are children, and so if the openness is there, they are very useful because it's very relaxed. You could play, and there are some that are just 10 minutes, there are others that are 2 hours. So for a specific tools, yes, there are plenty, and they are documented in a gamestorming.com, openly available.
Motivate people to actually use that, because that tends to be the problem, no?
Yeah, but the thing is to start the conversation first. If you feel that you don't need it, and then if you know there are plenty of ways, even if not playing, that is still introducing that, or it's more with managerial experience. The cake, which is very nutritious, yes, it's a tiny detail, but it's the kind of relax, exactly the kind of environment that we wanted to create in the data science. So it's like, yes, it's a very small detail, but it's relaxed. There are plenty of things that human resources are experts, and not human resources, I learn with them, to just create the right environment. And then it's just, can we iterate?
How often would you say does this happen in the real world?
What happened?
That this emphasis on soft skill is really, I would say, as important as, also in my opinion, it should be, especially in technical teams.
Okay, my experience, well, this is exactly the kind of white and black scenarios. Nobody has soft skills. No, that is not true. Even in technical environments, there are soft skills, and there are good soft skills. Soft skills, normally, if you have the experience that, like I had in Microsoft, of measuring your own soft skills with feedback from different perspectives, it's not just one or 10. It's something like 1, 2, 3, 4, and behind there are facts to say, yes, you are a 1, or you are a 3, or you are whatever. I just bring communications. There are more than 30 different soft skills. So the point here is, normally, I think this is a preconception that, oh no, technical teams do not have any kind of soft skills. No, that's not true. There are soft skills, there are improvements to do, but it depends on every team, and I have worked with very nice teams, very well working, and there are others that, well, just if the willingness is there, and at least the conversation is there, like, yes, maybe this is important, especially if you find yourself, like, there is no technical problem, the algorithm is here, but somehow, there is no implementation. There is not adoption of what we have done. And there are barriers, internal barriers in a company. It's exactly the point to review soft skills. And let's see which one. Because sometimes it's about understanding the politics internally, sometimes it's about communication, sometimes it's about dealing with ambiguity. Depends. But human resources could always, they have a very interesting value. I have partnered with human resources several times, and they could bring that to data science as well.
Do you think that the awareness, especially on C-level, is there that this is so crucial? Or is it often, it's my assumption, is it often more broken down to technical problems?
I think there is not awareness from my perspective, but the lack of awareness doesn't mean the lack of soft skills, which is different, okay? There are certain levels of soft skills, of course it could be improved depending on which is exactly the point and self-awareness, but I would say that there is a lack of awareness that soft skills are also important and investing in soft skills, because there are plenty of very easy tools and courses that is just one day, just an investment of the team. I said investment, not waste. Language is not innocent. Investment of one day of the team that will improve for the future. Okay. So, personally, it's my opinion, not the owner of the universal truth, but I think there is lack of awareness, not necessarily lack of soft skills, you know, in the whole spectrum. Any other questions?